New videos every day.
I recently did a video about ADHD, and just 2 days later, breaking news hit the media. I mean, this thing is international. It is everywhere. There's headlines in every newspaper, magazine. I mean, it is all over the internet. So I wanted to do a follow-up video on ADHD and tell you the news. So if it has anything to do with you or anyone you know, you want to hear this. Now, I want to just start off with reading through the headlines that are in all these different newspapers. They're from everywhere. And let me just read down the list. Peer calls for ADHD care review. Attention deficit drugs questioned. Report: ADHD drugs may stunt growth, long-term effectiveness unknown. Ritalin of no long-term benefit study finds. Drugs for ADHD not the answer. Controversy over effectiveness of ADHD treatment. ADHD medication may stunt growth. ADHD drugs have no long-term effects. ADHD drugs not a solution for a long-run treatment. The truth about treatments for ADHD. ADHD drugs under fire. ADHD drugs stunt kids' growth. Doping the young. The ADHD dilemma. And long-term use of Ritalin, ineffective, and may stunt children's growth. So what this news is all about is a study that was funded by NIH, the National Institute of Health, and it was a study that looked at 600 children since the early 90s, and it was this long-term study. Now, the first year of data showed that ADHD drugs were effective. So this data actually spurred this and caused this real big spike in prescription drugs for ADHD. But the study didn't stop after 1 year. So these children, these 600 children that have been studied, have been on these drugs for 3 years plus now. And guess what the data shows now? Now I gotta just read this to you from this article. Drugs used to treat attention deficit hyperactivity disorder have no long-term effectiveness and could stunt your child's growth. And scientists have conceded that test results that prompted the parental craze to dole out these drugs to their kids have been exaggerated. The multimodal treatment study of children with ADHD study concluded that while drugs such as Ritalin worked in the short term, there was no demonstrable improvement in children's behavior after 3 years of medication. Now, this next quote is from a professor from the University of Buffalo, Professor William Pelham. And he said that, "I think that we have exaggerated the beneficial impact of medication in the first study. We had thought that children medicated longer would have better outcomes, and that didn't happen to be the case." And this is really good. He points out why this article is so important. The children had a substantial decrease in their rate of growth, so they weren't growing as much as other children, both in terms of their height and in terms of their weight. And the second was that there were no beneficial effects. None. Now, this news is making big waves in the international community. For example, in Great Britain, Australia. Now, in Great Britain, there was a lady, her name is Baroness Greenfeld, and she has gone before Parliament and requested an inquiry into the number of increases in ADHD diagnosis. Now, this is what she has said. "As well as assessing ADHD drugs themselves, we also need to find out urgently why there have been such a remarkable increase in the numbers of children being diagnosed with ADHD in the last 20 years. And this is a great question she asked. Could the changes to our ways of living be contributing to this increase? And then she goes on to say, "The time is ripe for an inquiry exploring the actual causes of ADHD that goes beyond merely evaluating the pros and cons of Ritalin. Such an inquiry could consider the diverse factors ranging from diet to screen-based activity and how they may be changing the way both children and adults interact socially. Children living a fast-paced, highly interactive, response mode type of experience, and maybe as a result when they go to school, they find it harder to sit still." And then the National Institute of Clinical Excellence in Great Britain is said, after all this, you know, media attention, all these news has come out, that they're going to revise their treatment for ADHD, and they're going to incorporate parental counseling, training for parents, as well as behavioral interventions. So the big news here is that ADHD drugs used long-term are just not effective. But really, what do you expect? These mind-altering drugs taken long-term, eventually your body builds up a resistance and a tolerance to it, so they're not going to be effective in the long-term. So it just really looks like medication for ADHD is not a good solution in the long run. Now, if you're a parent or you know, a child, or you know someone who's taking ADHD drugs, I'm not telling you to stop your medication, but you may want to pull this information off of the internet, take it to your doctor, and discuss, you know, some therapies and some alternative things that will work for you. Now, I do have to warn you that when people go off caffeine, they can have significant withdrawal symptoms, but we're not talking caffeine here. We are talking about Schedule II narcotic, highly addictive substances. So if you're going to go off these drugs, make sure you're under medical supervision, because these withdrawal symptoms can be very, very substantial. Now, these drugs have been controversial for years, and earlier this year, the FDA had a special meeting, a committee meeting, to discuss adverse events and side effects of these ADHD drugs, and really the ways to warn those who are taking this drug. So I want to read you some parts of this FDA official release. And it says, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, today directed the manufacturers of all drug products approved for the treatment of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder to develop patient medication guides to alert patients to possible cardiovascular risks of adverse psychiatric symptoms associated with the medicines, and to advise them of precautions that can be taken. An FDA review of reports of serious cardiovascular adverse events in patients taking usual doses of ADHD products revealed reports of a sudden death in patients with underlying serious heart problems or defects, and reports of stroke and heart attack in adults with certain risk factors. Another FDA review of ADHD medication revealed a slight increased risk for drug-related psychiatric adverse events, such as hearing voices, becoming suspicious for no reason, becoming manic, even in patients who did not have previous psychiatric problems. Now, stick with me, and this has been long, but stick with me. Patient medication guides are handouts given to patients, families, and caregivers when a medicine is dispensed. The guides contain FDA-approved patient information that could help prevent serious adverse events. Patients being treated with ADHD products should read the information before taking the medication and talk to their doctors if they have any questions or concerns. Now, I went and pulled off a medication guide for Ritalin, and this medication guide is going to vary a little bit from other ADHD drugs, but this is what you're supposed to receive when you get a prescription for Ritalin at the pharmacy. And I just want to read you the information in these little black boxes, because these are the warnings. This is the information that you really need to know if you're taking these prescriptions. And this is the official approved language by the FDA. And it starts off by saying, what is the most important information I should know about Ritalin? And then it goes ahead and says, the following has been reported with use of Ritalin and other stimulant medicines. Number one, heart-related problems. And that includes sudden death in patients who have heart problems or heart defects, stroke and heart attack in adults, and increased blood pressure and heart rate. Tell your doctor if you or your child has any heart problems, heart defects, high blood pressure, or a family history of these problems. Your doctor should check your child carefully for heart problems before starting Ritalin. Your doctor should also check you or your child's blood pressure and heart rate regularly during treatment with Ritalin. And then the number two types of problems that have been reported with the use of Ritalin is mental psychiatric problems. And for all patients, this includes new or worse behavior and thought problems, new or worse bipolar illness, and new or worse aggressive behavior or hostility. And then specifically for children and teenagers, it says new psychotic symptoms such as hearing voices, believing things that are not true, are suspicious, or new manic symptoms. Now, I know we didn't talk about any alternative therapies and solutions for ADHD in this video, but I did make a video just a few days ago, and it's called ADHD Treatments Versus Possible Cures. So watch that video if that's what you're looking for. There's some great information in there. Now, this, you know, this video is all about showing the facts. The news is that long-term treatment using ADHD drugs is not effective. It's not a good long-term solution for ADHD. So there it is. There's the facts. Take care of yourself. Please rate this video, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.